Hi everyone, welcome back to the Organized Notebook. In this video, we will be doing a build with me of a weekly planner in Notion. First thing you'll want to do is open an empty Notion page, and let's title this weekly planner. And let's already change this into full width small text. Great, now the next thing we should do is add a cover photo. And let's change the cover photo to something, let's say, minimalistic this time. And let's go with this photo. Of course, you can choose whatever photo you want, and usually we use Unsplash if we're looking for a quick cover photo. They have a huge library. Let's reposition this. Great, so for this weekly planner, we're going to have two sections. One is going to be mainly the weekly planning section, and then we're also going to have a calendar so that you have a space to record important events. So for this, let's make two columns by typing slash column. And this side is going to be the weekly plan, and this side will be the monthly calendar. So you can just think of this as a paper calendar, a weekly paper calendar. We'll usually have weekly pages and then 1 month pages as well. And these are just placeholders to keep the columns in place. So it's going to look something like this. So for the weekly plan, we are going to have a list database. So let's type slash list. And you'll see list view. So let's click list view and new database. Great. And then in the monthly calendar, we're going to have a calendar database. So slash calendar. And we'll make another database called calendar view plus new database. So now we have two databases. One is just for your main events during the month. And one just to plan your week every week. So here we'll name this monthly calendar. And we like to hide database titles so it looks cleaner. So we're going to go ahead and click the three dots here. And we are going to hide database title. And let's rename this tab so it reflects what this is supposed to be, which is our monthly calendar. And you can even edit the icon here, but this looks fine, so we're going to keep it. And you basically already have a monthly calendar. So let's say you have a vacation, you can just put vacation and drag. So you can just see a very basic overview of your monthly schedule. And of course, you can add more properties and tags and everything, but for this purpose of a weekly planner, we are just going to leave it like this. So next we're going to go to the weekly planner section. So here as well, let's change the name into weekly plans. And we're going to name this weekly plans. And like the right side, we'll hide the database title. Go to layout and turn off show database title. So now we have a pretty minimal looking setup now, which is very nice. And the next thing we're going to do is create default templates for the weekly plans. So this is actually the most important part of this weekly planner. And for that, we are going to click the arrow button here under new and plus new template. Let's click there. And let's make this open in full page so we can see better. And for the setup, we're going to go for small text full width. And we'll call this weekly plan. And let's go over the properties that this database has, which is created in tags. And in this case, I think we can remove the created. So let's delete this property. And I don't think we need tags at the moment, so we can delete this property. And then let's add a property, which is the date. So this you set yourself. And I think that's it for our weekly plan. So the next thing we're going to do is create our weekly planner. So in a week, we have 7 days. And in this case, we're going to set up 7 call-out boxes, which are going to act as our places to write your plan or to do every day. So let's create a call-out box by typing /call-out. And let's choose an icon here. And in this case, it's going to resemble a paper calendar. So it could be nice to have something like a pin. Let's go with black. And this is going to be each day of the week. So we start with Monday. And let's bold. And to add a space under the text in callout box, you want to do shift and then enter. And then we're going to add to-do lists. So do /to-do to make a to-do list, and it somehow jumps out of the box. So we're going to put it back in the box. And you can duplicate these checkboxes by typing Command-D or Control-D. So for now, let's have 7 to-do boxes. Of course, when you start using it, you can use it however you want, but this is just to do the default template setup. So now let's duplicate this box by clicking the 6 dots here and clicking duplicate. And just so that we have a nice layout, we're going to move this box to the right side like this. So now we have 2 boxes side by side. And this is gonna be our Tuesday. And let's bold Tuesday. So now we can just keep duplicating until we have 7 boxes for the 7 days of the week. So duplicate, duplicate, duplicate. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And now we're going to move it on each side. So we have them in 2 columns. And then we are going to name them each Monday, Tuesday. Then we can have Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And let's make sure they're all bold so they look uniform. So it's like this. And then we basically have our weekly planner. So obviously as you use it, you're probably going to add different things, and you can even reorder them the way you want with the days. And actually, now that I think about it, I think it would be nice to add a property here called notes. So each weekly plan could have notes that you write in case you need to jot something down. So for this, we're going to add a text property. We're going to call it notes. And now you can just add whatever notes you want here. So this is your basic weekly plan. So now let's go back. And we go back. And now we have to set that plan as the default template for this database. So for that, we're going to click this arrow and then click the 3 dots here and set as default for all views in weekly plan. And now whenever you click plus new here, you're just going to get a new weekly plan with everything you just set up already. So these were the initial pages. So we're just going to delete these so we're not going to get confused. And now we can just test it out by clicking plus new here. And now you see weekly plan. And we can click this. And it should load the template that we just created. So you can see like this. So every time you click here, you're going to get a new weekly plan. And whenever you make a new weekly plan, you can just click next to date and set the whole week as the date so you can keep track better. So for that, you would do end date and click the start and the end. So now you can see that there is start and end date. And eventually you could even sort that all your weekly plans based on date by going to sort and sort by date. So this is going to be your basic weekly planner. So you'll have more weeks eventually, and it's just going to look like this. And every time you click here, you'll get your weekly plan and you'll be able to see the calendar. If you'd like the already completed free template, we have it in the description below. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial and let us know if you have any questions or thoughts. See you in the next one.